Hey guys, it's Bailey. Welcome back to the channel and thank you so much for tuning in to what's going to be my favorites. You might notice the background has changed. This is not permanent. I just like sat down and was ready for a change, so I used what I had, just some backdrops I had laying around. I'm not in love. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Bottom line is, if you don't like it, it's not here to stay. I'm not super fond of it, but still working with it. So let me know how you feel about it. You know the drill with these videos. I'm gonna be going through all of the products that I've been loving in the month of November. Makeup, bath and body, which I don't typically talk about, but I have some real favorites this month. So that being said, let's go ahead and dive in. First up is a rediscovered favorite. This is the Color Switch, and basically it's a way to clean your brushes, not sanitize your brushes, but rid your brush of existing powder, specifically colorful powder, without having to wash it with water, wait for it to dry, etc. You get the point. And basically, it's a spongy material inside here. You swirl your brush inside and the powder comes off on the sponge and your brush becomes relatively clean or free of colorful powder that will turn your what you think is taupe eyeshadow into hot pink eyeshadow. No one likes that surprise at 8 a.m. in the morning. I've had this guy for a while, but I tend to like to clean, like if I'm gonna go through the process of cleaning my brushes, I just use my Cinema Secrets, my big blue Cinema Secrets bottle to clean it, because that's easy enough in and of itself. But I've been traveling a lot lately. I feel like I'm blinding you with this. Sorry about that. I've been traveling a lot lately, and so I wanna pack as few liquids as possible. So this has been my best friend. And the one I have specifically actually has this little, I turned it upside down, but it's this white sponge in the center that you can dampen and then use that to foil your powders and then swirl it in there to clean it off if you want to use the same brush for multiple shades, obviously. But you have to, if you do wet that, they recommend you clean it with each use, and I don't have time for that, so I just flip it around and just don't bother. But highly recommend this if you are on the go or if you don't like to cleanse your brushes as much as you maybe think you should, but you still want that color gone and like a clean color palette for the next shade you want to apply, this is fantastic. In keeping with the travel favorites theme, I have some go-tos that I have been loving. First off, I feel like I've been talking about this a lot, but again, I don't like to pack liquids when I travel, so I try and use as many stick products as possible. That includes foundation. So I have been loving the Lancôme Tente Idole Ultra Wear Makeup Stick. Mine is in the shade 320 Bisque. And I mean, I love it this much. I'm almost donezo with it. And I meant to order it in the Sephora VIB sale and I totally spaced on it. So I'm just gonna have to buy this puppy at full price because it's worth it. I know I've talked about it a lot in other videos, but in case you're hearing this for the first time from me, in a nutshell, I like it because it's beautiful, buildable coverage, but it's so natural looking. It truly looks like second skin. It's not a super heavy, cakey stick foundation. Like, it's not your mom's stick foundation. It's just very lightweight, but gives your skin this beautiful, second skin, flawless finish. Next up is eyeshadow. I've been loving this guy, like I said, specifically for travel because I like a good mix of neutrals and colorful, like pops of color. This has it all, not only in the hues, but also in the textures, in the finishes. It's just such a good mix of matte neutrals. I love a good warm matte neutral, especially now that we're in the fall season. This was like my jam come Thanksgiving with these oranges and berries, but it also mixes it up with the texture where you have duochromes and shimmers and outright glitters. And I just loving having that kind of versatility, really regardless, but especially when I travel, because I only packed this palette and it had everything that I needed in it. Last up for makeup is a really oldie but goodie. It is the Rimmel and Kate Contour Palette Set. I don't know, they really don't put a clear name on this thing, but I feel like everyone will know it when they see it. This is in the shade Coral Glow, and basically mine has a well-loved bronzing panel, a nice coral blush shade, and a really beautiful but still very natural pearlescent looking highlight. I have actually been loving the Fenty Beauty Megawatt, whatever those dual shaded highlighters have been. For the highlight, I've been using this less, but it is truly beautiful if you want something buildable but still relatively natural. I digress. I love this because it is a 3-in-1 palette, so if all you want to take for your face is this, you're still set. You have everything you should need for a full contour, blush, and highlight, and the colors play so, so well together. Granted, it is very natural looking, so if you want like that pop of blush or just that pop of color or a little bit more drama within your contour, you're not gonna get that kind of versatility, but for me, this is like the no-brainer all-in-one face palette that I just have been loving to just pack and go. Okay, now onto some body products. I have discovered a new-to-me brand. One of my girlfriends sells this brand called Perfectly Posh, and I resisted for the longest time. Finally, I put my order in, and I am obsessed. So obsessed. Well, let's just get into it. You'll see how obsessed I am. So one of the things that I ordered is called a Snarky Bar. There are, I think, four different scents in this, and essentially it's an exfoliating bar, but it's a granular exfoliant of sorts. So the idea is that you get the bar wet, you kind of scrub it all over, and you're good to go. You have been exfoliated, whether it's for your daily exfoliant, it's before you self-tan. For whatever reason you need a good scrub, this is supposed to get the job done. So first of all, the scent that I have is Foapology, and it has this like plum bergamot, sort of the deeper muskier. If you know me, I love a good musky scent, and that is similar to what this is. I love that. So it fills your shower with that really good smelling scent. But then I have never had an exfoliant this effective. It feels, and this is a little weird, but a little like sandpaper on your skin, but it's not, I mean, it doesn't like damage your skin like rubbing sandpaper across it would. It just feels like you're getting this really deep, thorough exfoliation. And I've tried my fair share of shower exfoliators, whether it's like an in-shower scrub or a scrub in a tub or dry brushing, and I like them all just fine. It's just not something that I can typically sustain or maintain in my daily routine because I just never think to do it. It's one of those excessive products that stays in or out of the shower and it's like an extra step in my morning routine, and it's so easy to grab this bar and just like rub it. Speaking of, I particularly like to use this on my arms. I have KP, keratosis pilaris, which is basically a buildup of keratin in your hair follicle, and so it creates these little white bumps. This has helped with my KP so much because it regularly exfoliates that area, and I just noticed such a difference in using this, which I do think I would notice anyway if I were to exfoliate regularly, but because I remembered to use this, worlds of difference. Really love it for that. And then honestly, any place where you get any sort of ingrown, you just need that regular exfoliation to make sure the hair follicle is free and clear of dead skin cells or bacteria, things like that, I really love this for. Again, I said I'm obsessed. I love it so much that I bought a backup for me, and then the holiday season came and I bought all of the flavors they have to give to my friends and family. My sister has KP too, and so I think she's really gonna like it. And it's just really, it's a really nice smelling like shower experience. I don't know. So, huge fan, bought a ton of it, really recommend it. The other thing that I have really liked from Perfectly Posh, and my friend who sells it recommended both of these products to me, and she did not steer me wrong. So this is the Detox Body Mud, and essentially it's a clay-based, like a kaolin clay-based mask that sucks those impurities out of your skin. So if you have breakouts, anything like that, it just pulls it right out and detoxifies your skin. It comes in this huge tub. Part of the reason why I really want to check this out is because so many masks like that, they're meant for your face. You only use a little bit at a time, and it's not like you use it every day. But if you're looking for something for your body, if you have body acne on your back, I personally, like when I work out, get it on my chest. Body acne happens, folks, and I don't want to buy a teeny tiny little jar that's meant for your face. This is an entire tub of this stuff that I think is going to go a really long way, and I like the way it works. I've only used it a handful of times, and I do like to use my skincare for longer than that. I haven't had it for all that long, but in terms of things I've been loving lately over the past month, this has been it. And that's really it for me, guys. That's all of my the beauty favorites I've been loving anyway. I do have, if you're willing to stick around for a non-beauty favorite, I've been really digging podcasts, like a ton. No one in particular. I have like this long list of podcasts that I am continuously waiting for the fresh new upload for. But I'm always looking for recommendations, so if you have any you like to listen to, let me know down below. I am personally a true crime humor. Sounds weird, but it is a genre out there. And I also like marketing or beauty, obviously, but like the hybrid, like the Skinny Confidential kind of crosses those boundaries and kind of things like that. I would love to hear your podcast recommendations. Let me know down in the comments below, as well as, of course, any other beauty favorites you have. Love to hear those every month. Besides that, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye, guys.